I'm Haley Burchett, and I am the instructor and founder of Magic Tap Clogging here in Minot. We opened the studio a little over a year and a half ago now, and we've been going strong ever since. A little bit about me, I am a born and raised Kentucky girl, straight out of the South. And even though I've been in Minot for about 3 years, the accent still comes back pretty thick. Clogging is the state dance, actually, of Kentucky, and my mom grew up as a clogger. And she actually became a can-can girl when she was a teenager into her early 20s, and she performed at this place called Guntown Mountain, which is now Funtown Mountain in the hills of Kentucky. And I guess she was my biggest influence on the clogging side of things, but nothing can compare to entertaining on stage with my dad. My dad plays the banjo, and his dad played the banjo, and my mom's dad played the banjo. So banjos are forever in my family. Now, performing with him definitely taught me a lot about Appalachian music, where it comes from, and being able to clog to the music that he's written and created, especially on stage and putting a smile on people's face, that to me is priceless. Growing up with my dad traveling all the time, playing bluegrass music, there were little things that I treasured, and my grandmother kept this trinket. It's a music box, but it's in the shape of a banjo. And my dad actually gave it to her when he started playing music. And when I was a little girl and I'd go visit, I would take it and kind of play the music over and over. And it would kind of make me feel closer to my dad when he was far away. So clogging is all about creating your own rhythm with your feet. You have a buck tap on the toe, a tap on the bottom of the ball, and then a tap on the heel. And what's different from a tap shoe is the tap actually jingles. So you're not just getting a singular tap motion, tat, tat, tat. You actually have a double tap on top to create the da-da-da-da sound. The gals in the group. Jackie's the mom, very much the mom. She wants to make sure everyone and everything is exactly where it needs to be. And I respect that about her. Trista is the outspoken one, but she's kind of a loose cannon. You never really know what to expect with her, and that's always a lot of fun. Karen is like a mom, but she's more quiet, so you can tell that she had sons and not daughters. I think she's very grateful for that after seeing, you know, what it's like to work with women. But they're all so unique because they each bring something different to the fantastic team that we've assembled. I would be lost without each of them because they each bring something different to the fantastic team that we've assembled.
I first heard about clogging from Minot Daily News. It was originally offered as a clogger size class through adult education here in Minot. I guess I've always had an interest in Irish dancing is how I originally thought of it, or river dance. Just the expression, the sound, it really intrigued me. So I thought, here's maybe my chance. The sound in clogging is just, the best way I can describe it, I guess, is joyous. It just opens up something, and the joy just comes in and goes out, and I hope that that's what comes across when we perform, is how much we enjoy what we're doing, how much it touches our hearts, and hopefully it can touch the hearts of those who watch us.
I came into clogging through adult education. I work at a school. A sub came in and happened to mention clogging. I had seen clogging living 30 years in the South in Texas and Oklahoma. I saw clogging, absolutely loved it, but didn't have a chance to get enrolled in it at that time. So when she mentioned that she was giving a class, I jumped on it and met Haley through there. She was looking for people who were interested in continuing on, and I said yes and jumped right in. The reason I got into clogging is I love to dance, one, and rhythm, the beat. Clogging is all about that, and so it kind of combined two things that I love, and just allowed me to continue on. Something I could do beyond gymnastics and ballet and all that formal training, this was something I could keep dancing to. Clogging for me is partially about the exercise, but more about the dance, the me time, away from being a mom and a wife, and this is all about me, and I get to socialize with women who enjoy the same things I do. We just have a good time together and get to do what we love. The thing I would tell people about clogging is it's fun. You just need to come have fun. If you like music, if you like to move, it is fun, and you get to hear it with your feet because your feet make noise. So it's a great time, it's good exercise, it is a great group of women. You cannot beat it for something to do.
Well, I was at the gym, and that's where I heard about it. There was a lady who was doing clogercise, and she said there was a place in town that she's learning how to clog. So I was already involved in clogging quite a while back in my high school years, so I said, okay, well, I'd like this lady's phone number. Well, I love to dance, and I love to clog. I've belonged to a few other groups in North Dakota here, and I just wanted to continue on with my steps and learning more about how to clog. I love to dance. I grew up dancing with my parents. They taught me how to dance at the age of 5, and we used to dance around the house when we were set up the Christmas tree. I would tell them to go because it's fun. It's great exercise. If you love music and you love to dance, it's a new way to express yourself in dancing. And you don't need a partner to dance to clogging, which is the best part. So if you're not married or you're single, it doesn't matter. You can still dance and enjoy yourself. We get along really well. Sometimes we have disagreements, but that's normal between women in general. Everybody's unique in their own way and brings their own opinion about things, about songs and how we're going to choreograph, which really helps. Yes, I would recommend this. Get your get rhythm when you get the blues. A little shoe shine boy, he never gets low down, but he's got the dirtiest job in town. Bending low at the people's feet on a windy corner of a dirty street. Will I ask him while he shines my shoes how to keep from getting the blues? He grinned as he raised his little head, he popped his shoe shine rag, and he said, get rhythm.